Okay. Now, let's re read the question again. Suppose I tell you x1, x2, x3 is a sequence of RID random variable, or you say it's a simple random sample from normal population with mean equal to mu x and variance equal to sigma squared. And also, y1, y2, y3, y4 is a sequence of RID random variables from normal population with mean mu y and sigma y squared. Question number one, what is the sampling distribution of X bar? What is the sampling distribution of what? Sample mean from X population. And question two, what is the sampling distribution of Y bar? And then what is the sampling distribution of X bar minus Y bar? Okay? Now, first one, if you read my YouTube video, T distribution, you should know this already, okay? We know the normality. Normality is closed under linear combination. The normality is closed under linear combination. What does that mean? Suppose we have two random variables, two normal random variables. Say S and T are two normal random variables. Okay, and C is a non zero constant. Okay, say S and T are two normal random variables, and C is a non-zero constant. Then we have S is normal cross what? T is normal. Okay? Let me try one more time. Say S and T are two normal random variables, and C is a given non-zero constant. Is not equal to zero. Okay? Not equal to zero. Then two normal random variables, either you add them together or you subtract them together, it still remains as what? As a normal random variable. Still normal. It is still normal. Okay? Still not normal. And B. A constant, a non-zero constant, times S, the normal random variable, still what? Still normal. This is what we call the normality is closed under linear combination. So let's look at question one now, okay? What is the sampling distribution of X bar? Our first question. We know X bar can be written as x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3. Okay? That is to say, 1 over 3 times x1 plus 1 over 3 x2 plus 1 over 3 x3. Okay, look at here. 1 over 3 is a non-zero constant. And norm x1 follow normal. So a constant times normal, still normal. Same thing, 1 over 3 x2, normal. 1 over 3 x3, no, is still normal. Normal plus normal, still normal. And this 2 plus 1, 1 over 3 x3 is still normal. So the sampling distribution of x bar, it follows still what? Normal. That's not good enough. We also need to find what? Its mean and its variance. Okay? And what's mean of x bar? Mean of x bar is expected value of 1 over 3 x1 plus 1 over 3 x2 plus 1 over 3 x3. By the property of expected value, okay? By the property of expected value. Remember we covered this before. Expected value of a constant is a constant itself, okay? Expected value of a constant times a random variable is a constant times expected value of that random variable, okay? And then expected value of x plus y is ex plus y plus ey, okay? Property 1, property 2, property 3, okay? So let's do that. First, use property 1 to tear this one into 3 pieces. Expected value of 1 over x, 1 over 3 x1, plus expected value of 1 over 3 x2, plus expected value of 1 over 3 x3. Since a constant can be pull out the expected what operator, okay? So let's do that. So this is 1 over 3 ex1 plus 1 over x ex2 plus 1 over 3 expected value of x3, okay? But you know each one is what? Each one, as we given earlier, is mu x, okay? All three, they have the same mean because that's what we call identical, okay? Each one is mu x1, mu x1, mu x1. So you have 3 mu x1 added together divided by 3. So that's just what? That's just mu x. Similarly, this is not just restricted to what? 3. For any number n, it also works. So expected value, even size, sample size is n, even sample size is n. Ex bar is always equal to mu x. Mean of the sample means is equal to population mean. Mu x is a population mean. Okay.